And here we are on TV Conference Championship. Indianapolis Colts at home. AFC. AFC Conference Championship. Indianapolis at Denver. 10-6 versus
16-0. Hello, everybody. It's the coach. This is a special edition of the AFC Championship game on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got what should be an interesting matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Denver Broncos. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Well, Coach, as far as home field advantages go in the playoffs, there are few places tougher on a visiting team than this one. Sold out Empowered Field at Mile High in Denver. Straight ahead, it's a clash to decide the AFC's representative in the Super Bowl. And it'll be a great one between the Indianapolis Colts and the Denver Broncos. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talked about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Seattle. Who will it be? Seahawks or the Falcons? Man, I'm not sure about that one.
Nothing on the scoreboard. 0-0 as the offense gets ready to take over the football. Midfield inside the 45. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it, but it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
Let's go. Get set. Ready.
Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. And a good burst there right from the start as he'll get this one out near the 35. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. He may try and run for this. He'll get the first down more inside the 20. And all the way down to the 5. But he will finally be taken down, but not before he gets it to the Colts 5.
And that was a nice, strong run by the guy they call the field general.
Thank you. It's first and goal. A chance for the first points of this AFC title bout. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. It's their quarterback, keeping it himself from 5 yards out as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive?
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
218, chop, get it.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down.
Now, that was pretty. They executed that current route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, a tight, sharply run route. Again, zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A big time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
First on travel.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Second and 3. He completes this to Sutton. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Tally, that is catch number 1 for him in this AFC championship. It's a first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
And he'll take it down to the end zone for a Denver score.
Bulldog.
Their mobile quarterback with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Broncos have taken the lead. Well, Charles, he's already proven that he's not afraid to tuck that football down on the option, and he's into the end zone for the second time in the game.
Thank you, defense.
So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, a run with Lindsey. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Broncos first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Oh, threw it behind him. How is that? I even let him know what to throw it.
Cortland Sutton was the man he was looking for. And now it's second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Now that's twice now already in this first quarter that he's been able to knock a ball away.
They're going to need that from him and plenty more if they want to slow down this passing game. Thus far, though, he's been a ball magnet.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. He'll look to throw. He He's got a man. It's Sutton. That's complete. Second catch of this AFC title game, but he's got a first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. On first and 10, it's Lindsey. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Out of the gun now on third down. Got a man open, it's Sutton. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 39.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Ooh, come on, and there we go.
Three. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A big time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down.
Halfback lead guy.
90 Wolf. Check 55 to Mike. You don't know no better. Five.
They'll run on first down. Lindsey. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
We're going to audible RPO zone. Yep. We're going to try and give it to Hamilton.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Deshaun Hamilton, the intended receiver. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down.
I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost. And now there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. From 8 yards.
Triple option.
So
let's
now
give
this
it a
offense
shot.
Will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. Hey. 6 yards there on the keeper. It's 2nd down.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
On play action, they'll throw.
Throwing over the middle, that's incomplete.
The free safety, Malik Hooker, there in coverage.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Ben Gideon in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to 4th down.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. And he gets it away, and it's a laser headed for the sidelines. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way in.
Strong
we pick it up 2nd quarter here as the offense gets ready for the drive. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds,
out of
says
bounds.
The line judge. The throw took him a little
too far, 2nd down.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. And he's going to have to hook up to Sutton. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco 1st down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more
weaving through traffic, and now he's fighting. And all the way home for a Broncos score. A big play there. On his way to a historic performance, 4 first half touchdowns. And the Broncos push further out in front. On this stage, conference championship game, every play is magnified, and that was a big play.
No doubt about it. One thing that has these guys a step away from a shot at the big game, their big play ability.
Just set a new record. Wow, so that is 4. Nice. So 2 more and I got a record.
So we are in the second quarter now as the offense gets set to take over. They've got it first and 10.
And that's not even.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Under 10. Under 10. 10. General West.
Audible to 6.
Shoot.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This is the tight end fan. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys, we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
He's got a first down.
Oh, I still got around
inside the 40. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Pretty nice play here. They go read option, read the defensive end, and when he collapsed down inside, how about the quarterback pulling it, keeping it, and not only getting to the second level, but picking up some really nice yardage.
Very, very well read. He'll pick up 7 there on the first down keeper. AFC title game, second quarter action, 2 minutes to play.
Lot out.
A reminder, as we've done all year, we'll send you to Orlando for our EA Sports halftime report in a bit. The coach is with us per usual as we start to look ahead, Charles, to our potential matchups in this year's Super Bowl.
Break it down, coach. Break it down.
That one, a first down pickup of 8. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
He's got slant caught, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. The quick slant, good for 8 and a first.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. You got to deliver the ball on time.
And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. It's their quarterback keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Broncos push further out in front. And that rushing touchdown is 4th, puts him just 1 shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game.
This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter.
And of course, it's not Lindsay again.
Let's put that team on the box.
They'll start the third quarter here on the ground. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on the tackle, and that's going to tack on 15 more. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that would look pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Second and 11. Over the middle, and it's
no flag. Dude was in the way. I couldn't get around him. Oh, my God.
Throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll look to throw here. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kenny Moore. And a big turnover there as his...
Thank you, defense.
After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. And a productive gain out to the 14 after starting at the 7. It's a gain of 7. Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. On first down, he'll drop to throw.
He's being held.
Escaping the pass, he's taken down. Trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket.
He's being held. He's trying to get around the guy.
Justin Houston just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
Okay, was it a breakdown of protection? Did the running back not pick him up? It doesn't really matter. Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Good job, Noah.
It's a big play there for the Broncos. 42 yards.
Halfback
swing. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now it's Lindsey.
Ran right into the guy. Dude.
They follow up that gigantic game with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
A man's gonna lose with the football there, right? Interception before, almost had one here. He's got to start taking better care of it.
Yeah, really should have been back-to-back drives with interceptions. He's lucky there. First down marker at the 31. It's third down. They'll look to throw. He's got his tight end fan. And they will eventually get him down. He's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Just more of the same there, partner. Guys have just been running free in the secondary this entire game. No pass rush, a lot of passes completed. It's been an easy day for him.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. It's their quarterback. A 3-yard run as he kept it himself. As his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Well, they've been part of the cream of the crop in the AFC all season. It's becoming more and more evident that they're going to get a shot to play for that Super Bowl title.
The momentum has been building, and you mentioned how well they've played throughout the season. It's all come together for them, and they are really laser-focused on being that team to represent in the Super Bowl.
They have been dominant in this one. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun, and he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Yeah. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
147 yards rushing. Holy shit.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Shit.
On first
down. I got the hand up.
It's Lindsay. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. The last run got nine. That leaves them with second and a yard. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Enough for the first down.
Gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
65th first down. Yes, Mike. First down, Jack.
Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. One quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
I think it's pretty much a given we're going to the Super Bowl.
Ready? Eight reads. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. A loss of two there. Second down.
Brings up second and 12.
Here we go on second and 12.
Dang.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Darius Leonard, the linebacker, able to break that one up. The Broncos on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third down and 12. Now back to throw. And that will be incomplete. Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, that part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have one right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribed, right? When you talk about winning that turnover battle.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. The drive will commence with a run by Lindsay, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. A gain of 3, second down. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. They'll go again with Lindsay, and the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The Broncos on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and 8. Looking to throw.
God.
And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Go, go!
So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball. Be
careful, be careful. And an alley to run. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
Five
the keeper
five
there turning
five
into
rushing.
A big play of 23 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Well, that last run for a first down, it really shouldn't be the last straw for the defense. I don't care how many they've had in the box, they need to add more people.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. This is caught inside the 15. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Come on.
And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. And they're going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
That should
feel. Well, there it is. After number five, we were wondering if we would see it, and he has broken the NFL record with his sixth touchdown of this game.
Let's face it. We can go ahead and lose our objectivity here, can't we, and just applaud what we've seen. That's one of the great records in the NFL. Are you talking about this number six touchdown?
And with this win and an AFC championship, they have reached the most hallowed ground in all of sports.
That means they are the best in their conference. What an incredible feeling for this team to go through the entire season and come out on top and now go to the Super Bowl for the right to be called world champion.
And that does it for the conference championship. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And for our entire crew, we'll see you 2 weeks at the Super Bowl. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
In the conference championship game. Wow. .308 yards, 6 touchdowns on 25 attempts. Well, let's see who we go against in the Super Bowl. Do I get a Pro Bowl? Probably not. Still. Because I'm not a very good passer. Not even It's gotta be because of my lack of passing. It's the only thing I can come up with. And I'm fucking kicking ass here. Leading undefeated teams. Well, leading Super Bowl champions. This year we went undefeated. I lost one or two in past seasons. Undefeated this time around. Took 4 years. My game too cold, made it shiver, but I'm still a hot boy, cool down, let it simmer. Against the Atlanta Falcons, and they went 9-7. Got a feeling this might be a quicken. As expected, MVP. My mama stopped working, that's the promise. Mama. Going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. How can I be the best QB but not be in the Pro Bowl? I don't get it. Alright, we'll be back for the Super Bowl.